If there actually is something wrong with this vaccine, or there appears there may be something wrong with this vaccine, what does it mean for the global vaccination effort? And even here in the U.S., we've stockpiled about 10 million doses of that AstraZeneca vaccine.
Well, if, and again, that's a big if, because we've not gotten any scientific analysis yet from regulators or others looking into this, it could be a big problem, at least for many of the big economies that you just mentioned in Europe, because so many of those countries had bet on getting the AstraZeneca vaccine into the arms of their citizens by now and over the next several weeks and months. So if there is an issue with that, that means there's going to have to be quickly, everyone's going to have to quickly pivot to get more deals with some of the other vaccine manufacturers. But it's easier said than done, of course, because these manufacturers are already under pressure to ramp up production as quickly as possible to get vaccines out to countries with which they already have contracts. And they're going to have to then suddenly find ways to develop or rather produce even more to compensate for what is needed in Europe and elsewhere. So you can see right away that the global effort to try and vaccinate everybody and develop herd immunity from corner to corner around the world is going to get slowed down dramatically very quickly.
All right, Ed, important to remind everyone that on Thursday, European regulators, they're going to release their findings. Right now, we don't have a definitive answer. You said it, but we want to make sure we say there is no definitive answer about this blood clot issue. But I want to ask you, you said everybody's going to have to try to find more vaccine. Is everybody in the same boat? Are big countries like Germany and the biggest economy in Europe, as well as developing countries who get the vaccine from the WHO, are they in the same boat and will they feel the same impact?
Well, it varies around the globe, of course. To the extent that AstraZeneca got a big jump last year because the company has been working with Oxford University in the UK. So there was some cachet there, and the Oxford University folks were talking it up last year, and there was a lot of excitement as a result. The European Union struck a deal last summer with AstraZeneca initially for 300 million doses. So right away, there was a lot of anticipation that AstraZeneca's vaccine would be a savior. And as a result, as I mentioned before, many countries were counting on this. But there have also been deals with other manufacturers, of course. So it's not necessarily uniform effect everywhere you look. The problem is that these countries are going to have to rely on, as I said, other manufacturers. But there's also another wrinkle here, which is that the World Health Organization, working with some nonprofits and foundations last year, launched a program they call COVAX, which is designed to get vaccine to more than 90 low and middle income countries around the world that can't easily afford to pay up like wealthier countries can and do their own deals. And COVAX made a deal with AstraZeneca early on so that the AstraZeneca vaccine would be made by other companies in other countries. A big example, the Serum Institute of India. And these other deals were supposed to facilitate the supply and distribution of the vaccine, the AstraZeneca vaccine, to these dozens of other countries. And so if these countries can't get the vaccine through COVAX, well, they also suffer the same kind of setback that wealthy nations do in trying to get their citizens inoculated and achieve some degree of herd immunity. So you can see the ripple effects when you add all that up and step back, look at the planet as one big challenge.
Definitely a serious situation there, Ed. It sounds like developing nations would have an even harder time pivoting to a different vaccine because they were counting on this AstraZeneca vaccine through the WHO. So I think a lot of us here in the U.S. are wondering, why was the AstraZeneca vaccine the vaccine of choice in Europe and for these other developing nations? Here in the U.S., we saw the Moderna and the Pfizer vaccine roll out first. Any reason this was the vaccine of choice? And before this blood clot issue, did the AstraZeneca vaccine have a smooth rollout?
Well, again, the AstraZeneca vaccine got a lot of good publicity early on. And it had the imprimatur of Oxford University scientists along with it. Also, AstraZeneca had said that it would sell the or make the vaccine available on a not-for-profit basis, at least until the vaccine, the pandemic was declared officially over by the WHO. So there are a lot of nice pieces in place, and all of which sounded good. And AstraZeneca is based in Europe, so it had sort of, I wouldn't say a home advantage, but there was Europe was favorably disposed to look at AstraZeneca as a lead option for getting through this crisis. Here in the U.S., the Operation Warp Speed, as it was called by the Trump administration, was working with different companies, striking different kinds of agreements to get vaccine supplies in place for the United States. And AstraZeneca is just one. As you mentioned, they have a stockpile, but it's not been granted emergency use yet, authorized emergency use by the FDA, as the other vaccines have. As Americans have heard, we can get a Pfizer vaccine, a J&J vaccine, a Moderna vaccine once there's enough of them. But AstraZeneca has not yet been granted that status. Nonetheless, the U.S. decided, as you mentioned, to keep that stockpile in reserve for the time when the FDA does grant that status. So, but right now, that's of course in question.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.